bring out through his glory. But that's not what I have a problem with. I don't struggle with that. Because I know it's inevitable. I struggle with the fact that after you went to heaven, I've had kids. I'm scared to death that at three, they're going to go and they're going to die. That's what I struggle with every day. So I know once they're past three, for some reason, I'm like, okay, they're good. And the only reason I'm saying this is because I'm struggling and I'm pushing and praying because Zoe's three. She doesn't turn four till August. And I know, and I push and I pray and I pray. Because deep down I know that she's not going to die right now. But that's my struggle. That's what the devil throws at me every day. So it's hard for me to go to work every day. And I'm not with my daughter. It's hard for me to stay away because I think if I'm not there and something happens, I'm not there. I can't prevent it because I was there when my son passed away. I was there and I thought in my head, what can I have done to prevent it? I was there. So when I leave my kids or I have a hard time, that's my big, big stumbling block. And the only reason I go to sleep at night, like I said, is because of God. I have nightmares. And I've had to pray through. I've never even told Pastor Sean. Because I feel like if I say it, it's going to happen. I feel like if I speak it out, because I've always been taught, don't speak it out. And I hold that in. There's a lot of things I hold in that I don't tell anybody. I don't even tell Pastor Sean. Because I'm scared if I speak it out, it's going to happen. And I know, because I was mostly raised in church, I know that it's not in this situation, but that is my big stumbling block. I have gotten over so many things in my life. I've gotten over a mother that was abusive to drugs, that did not care about her kids, that was thrown to the side. I've gotten over literally beatings every day for 19 years. I've gotten over all of that. I've gotten over my son going to heaven at a young age. And nobody wants their kids to go to heaven at a young age. It's hard. That scripture, stand. No matter what, stand. So when Donnie would turn three, I had to pull up church and stand. I know he's three. I know he's three. My son was three and a half. He was almost four. So that's what the devil throws at me every day. Now Zoe's three. Thank gosh I can't have no more kids. But yeah,
me neither.
That's what I fight every day. The devil doesn't just throw things at the congregation. He throws things at the pastors, at people behind the pulpit. He knows that we're all on our way to heaven. So anything that he can throw at you, he's going to throw at you. Anything that he can throw to trip you up, to stumble you, to make you fall, and he'll do it more than once. It's not just, well, he threw this at me today, so I'm going to get up, dust myself off, and go on, and he'll leave me alone. He'll come back. Comes back the next day. Well, she thinks that she's victorious, but guess what? I'm coming again. He will always come at you as long as you're serving God. When you're not serving God, that's when the devil says, well, they're going to hell, so I don't want to mess with them. They're already on their way. So when you're going, you think that you're going through hell, that means that you're serving God and you're doing something right. Because the devil's going to keep throwing things at you. But you need to stand. If someone comes at you with a bat, with a knife, with a skillet, you're going to block them, right? You're not just going to stand there and let them stab you or hit you. Well, that's what the devil does. It may not be, you may not be able to see it and come running at you with a skillet or something. But that's what he's going to do. He's going to bring something that's going to hurt you to the table. He's love. He doesn't care what it is. He doesn't have a heart. He does not care. So when he brings those things to you and he thinks he has you defeated, push him back. Stand. If you got to kick him, kick him. I mean, if you got to throw a fit and throw a temper tantrum, put all, you know how the kids go throw their body weight? Oh, do that. Throw your body weight down. Let him know who you are. And when he comes to put something on you, he'll hesitate. What does she have now? I'm going to do it anyway, just in case. Just in case. What if this is the one that knocks them down? What if this is the one that gets them to turn away? Oh, I got offended. I got offended in church because they didn't shake my hand. Why can't everybody hug? Why can't we all be huggers? I like to hug, but I'm not a big hugger. I'll shake your hand. I'll give you high fives. But I'm not a big hugger. Or if you think, well, they see me in public and they didn't wait. I know they see me. And they look right at me. That's it. I'm done. Don't let the devil come in with petty little things to try to let you fall away from God. And with, like me, the stumbling block that the devil tries to give me is that it may not be the same with you. Yours may be something different, something totally we wouldn't even think about. You know, it may not be big to us, but it's big to you. Because yeah. You may not think it's big. Oh, well, it's because they're turning three, really. You know, it may not be big to you. It's big to me. Or, you know, road rage. It may not be big to me, but it's big to you if you have road rage. And that's your big stumbling block. You know, it doesn't matter how big or how small that we think it is. To the devil, we think it doesn't matter. As long as it hits you to fall away, that's all it takes. That's all it takes is one thing that we let the devil in. And we let him take our joy. We let him take our victory. We let him take our freedom. One thing. And it could be a little bitty tiny thing. You know, but well, they said that I was off key on that song. I don't think I'm going to leave now. And I'm going to find someone that loves my off-pitch voice. So that is not my stumbling block, because I don't care if you come off pitch. I will sing it louder. But always remember to stand. Get that scripture. Whatever you have, whatever the devil is trying to throw at you in life, put on your armor of God. Stand. Stand every day. Don't sit down. Don't lay down. Because it makes you vulnerable to the devil. When you lay down spiritually, you sit down spiritually, you stand. Because when you're standing, you're on guard. When you're sitting up straight in your car and you're not laid back, I feel like Pastor Sean's like, can only see the top of the steering wheel. And it scares me. I don't like riding with him, it scares me. It can make me sick, it can drive crazy, and it scares the crap out of me. It's just scary. I feel like I've got to sit this far from the steering wheel, and I got to sit up. I got to see, because I feel like I'm more aware, more safe. I got to get rid of the car, I got to be safe. Even though it's not good to sit that close to the steering wheel so that somebody hits you, they're right. But I don't care. I have a seatbelt on. But when you're standing, you're upright. You can see everything. When you're laying down, you're vulnerable. Someone can kick you. Someone can push you. The devil can kick you and push you and get you down further than what you already are. But when you're standing, it's harder to push somebody down when they're already standing. And they are aware. They are focused. You know, when the other day, Toby's having a hard time with bullying. Okay, he's a wee little baby. He's just little. He's 13 almost. And he's just little. So he was sitting down in his chair, and a girl wanted the dime he had. It was a girl, and she punched him in the chest. So I can't breathe. I said, "Well, what were you doing?" I was sitting down in the chair, and I was just playing on the phone. Well, it's because you probably didn't know what I was supposed to be doing. I said, "If you would have been standing there, if you would have been paying attention, you wouldn't have got hurt." I said, "I'm sorry, I can't do anything about it because I'm at work and you're at school." "Did you tell the teacher?" "No, didn't tell the teacher." "I'm not going to make a big deal out of it if he doesn't tell the teacher." But I told him, I said, "You need to be aware. You need to be aware of your surroundings." I said, "When you're on the bus, you have your cell phone out, not paying attention." So he's got kids that pick on him on the school bus. His kid's bit him twice because he wants his cell phone. "Yeah." I said, "Put that cell phone in that backpack. Zip it up. Get off that cell phone. Pay attention." Because the more that you are not aware of your surroundings, the more something is going to happen. He's like, okay. We're walking into Walmart. There he goes with that cell phone, not paying attention. One of these days, he's already walked into poles. He's already walked into walls. One of these days, he's going to walk into a car, and I'm going to say, "I told you to pay attention." You know, me and Pastor Sean laugh at him, but I tell him, if you're on something, you're not paying attention. If you're on your cell phone, you're not paying attention. Anybody can come up and snatch you. If you are focused on other things besides God, the devil will come and get you. He will throw things at you, and it will knock you over because we're not paying attention. Our focus is on something else. So we need to stand, be focused, be aware, know that the devil will come. He's never going to stop. He's not ever going to say, "Today is my day off. I'm not going to mess with you today." He will never stop. So know that as long as you're serving God, the devil's going to come at you with everything that he can. Everything. So you always have to be ready to fight. It's our job. We're Christians. We have a war, a spiritual war, that we're fighting every day. Always pray for one another. Lift everyone in this church up. Always very, very important. Iron sharpens iron. So we need to pray for each other. The devil is hitting hard. Very hard. Because he wants this church
foot.
He knows that we are doing, that we're doing a good deed. He knows we're going to make a difference. He knows that something's fixing to happen. So the harder he hits, the more we know something's fixing to happen. Something's fixing to explode. So always keep your pastors in your prayers every day, every day. If not more than one time a day, like always. But always know that you can count on the Word of God. Get your scripture. And if you have to write it out, type it out, post it on your wall, quote it every day, get that scripture to help you to stand so you don't fall. Because it's hard when the more you fall to get back up. The devil keeps pushing and pushing, and you keep falling, and you keep falling, and you keep falling, and you go, you know what? I'm done picking myself up. I'm done. It's harder to get back up the 15th time you fall, and your knees start to hurt. So we have to, before the devil can knock us down, we need to knock him down. Know that he's coming. And stand on God's word.
That's good.